Mabuhay everyone, Mark Chess here and welcome to the channel. Welcome for all of you new subscribers or new viewers and hope you like my videos here where you can learn a lot. Hopefully it will help you choose your future sneaker. And in today's video, I will be doing a comparison video between two very new sneaker from Nike. It's actually a team sneaker. Both are team sneakers rather. On my left is the Zoom BB NXT, Zoom BB Next, or the Zoom Rise 2. This is what actually I call the big brother and the little brother in team shoes from Nike. Both are amazing performers, but which sneaker would you prefer? I'll help you with that. Let's go. Before we start off, if you want to watch the full performance review of each of these sneakers, I'll be putting the link down in the description below or up here, whichever tickles my fancy. And let's start off first with the upper of these two sneakers. Both sneakers have mesh upper, but it has a different level of mesh. On the Zoom BB Next, it has a mesh knit kind of feel to it compared to the more traditional mesh or fleece mesh that you can see here in the Zoom Rise 2. The main difference that I can see right now is the thickness of the mesh. The mesh on the Zoom Rise 2 is a lot thicker. The BB Next upper feels a lot softer right off the box compared to the Zoom Rise 2, which you have to break it in a little bit because it's more fused. So you have to warm up the material first, then it will become a lot softer. In terms of support, I would say the traditional mesh in the Zoom Rise 2 is more supportive because it's a lot thicker, but nothing to take away from the mesh knit of the BB Next. It's still very supportive. It doesn't stretch. It's very durable in all the areas that you need. In the toe box area, you can see it has more fusing, like the Mamba skin that you can find around the edge of the toe box, which gives more durability to the upper of the BB Next. Well, on the Zoom Rise 2, there's an underlining fabric around the forefoot area, which also gives you durability and support around the forefoot area of the Rise 2. And moving to the back part of the sneaker, both are still mesh, but like I said in the beginning, the main difference between the material is the dotted area, which I think gives us extra support and rigidity of the material of the BB Next. The bigger the dots are, the thicker and more supportive the areas are. And those are the high wire areas where you put a lot more pressure laterally and medially or forward and backward motion of the sneaker. The Zoom Rise 2's upper, all throughout, it's kind of the same thickness, but at the back there's a foamy part to it, and both have internal heel TPU plate for heel containment, lockdown and support. And in terms of heel containment, I would give it more towards the Zoom Rise 2. Both are my true to size, both are US 11. But I think if I want more support or heel containment on the BB Next, I can go half a size down, and I think there's still be room for me around the toe area because I just bought this online, so I didn't get to try it out. So I went to the safer side, went true to size, but I think I can go half size down on the BB Next. While on the Zoom Rise 2, it fits me perfectly. So I went true to size on this. And I think one of the main factors is there's a thicker heel cushion, Achilles cushion here in the Zoom Rise 2 compared to the BB Next, which has a thinner heel cushion, but both are very supportive and comfortable. But I like the thickness of the foam around the heel of the Rise 2 better because it can lock down my heel and Achilles more compared to the Zoom BB Next, which has a little bit thinner material. So both are very easy to put your foot in, very easy to customize the fit around the midfoot. It has a traditional lacing system. I would prefer the laces on the Zoom BB Next because it has a flatter lace compared to the more rounded laces found in the Rise 2, because over time when you're playing, the rounded laces tends to loosen up over time compared to a flat lace, which really holds up and doesn't loosen up even if you wear the sneaker for a very long time. So I prefer a flat laces over the rounded laces, but I like the more layers of lace loops found in the Rise 2 because the Rise 2 has 7 layers of lace loops compared to the 5 layers found in the BB Next, which you can customize more of the fit if you have more lace loops, if you want to tighten the forefoot, if you want it to be tighter around the midfoot or the ankle area. It's easier to customize if you have more lace loops. I just wish that they added more lace loop to the Zoom BB Next, especially around the forefoot area, where you can improve the lockdown fit and support of the BB Next. Now moving on to the cushion of these two sneakers. Both have amazing cushion. Really impressed with these two sneakers. It's just a matter of preference, in my opinion. If you want a more low profile court feel responsive cushion with a good impact protection, go with the Rise 2 because it has a huge zoom unit. It's very low to the ground. I think there's a little bit of phylon in between your foot, the insole, and the zoom and the outsole, so making it really low to the ground around the forefoot area, and a little bit thinner cushion or injected phylon around the heel part of the sneaker, making it really low to the ground. There's enough impact protection and very, very bouncy forefoot cushioning, and you will feel it more when you're running and jumping. But on the BB Next, well, just walking with this, you can immediately feel how plush the cushion, because it has a full length React compared to the full length injected phylon of the Rise 2. This has full on React, very plush in the forefoot and on the heel. Maximum impact protection. You can see the difference on thickness of the cushion at the heel part of the sneaker, thus making the BB Next have more impact protection around the heel. While on the forefoot area, the feeling is very bouncy, very plush, and you can really feel your forefoot sinking a bit, then springing back. While on the Zoom Rise 2, there's not much sinking, just boink, springing. If that's a better way to explain it, there's no plushness around the forefoot. It's more of the bounciness that you immediately can feel. But the only downside of the BB Next is it is a little bit higher off the ground. So if you don't mind it to be higher off the ground, go with the BB Next for maximum cushioning and impact protection. And don't worry guys, on the BB Next, although it's higher off the ground, it is still very stable around the forefoot area. But in my opinion, it's not as stable as the ones that you will feel on the Rise 2, because it's lower to the ground and there's lesser cushion or plushness around the forefoot. So it's more stable around the forefoot. If you are not changing between these two, you wouldn't notice it that much, and your foot and your mental thinking will adjust while you're playing with the Zoom BB Next. So it's just really a matter of preference. If you want maximum cushion, if you have knee problems, and if you are more on the heavy side, the BB Next is better for you. While if you're a quicker guard, but you want it to be bouncy and very supportive, of course, the Rise 2 is for you. Moving on to the traction of both sneakers. The traction pattern on both sneakers are almost the same on some areas. Both are very wavy, but on the Rise 2, it's more circular and more spiral, giving it a more Kobe 9 traction feel. While on the BB Next, it's more of a LeBron feel to it because of the spiral pattern found in the Zoom pods. But all throughout, it's wavy. It's more wavy than the LeBrons. While on the traction of the Rise 2, it is decoupled, which I really love. It lessens the weight of the sneaker. But the React cushion found here on the BB Next makes the sneaker really light. So just a matter of preference. But I like the decoupled outsole because it can flex more around the midfoot part. But this one is not that bad either. And two of the highlights found on the outsole of both sneakers is the groove found in the forefoot area. So the purpose of that groove, very similar to the LeBron 17, is to enable the zoom to expand and unlock the zoom. And also another nice touch to the Rise 2 is, since it's decoupled, the zoom unit is a little bit exposed around the midfoot part, making the zoom unit unlock more because it's more exposed compared to the two zoom pods found in the BB Next. Although the React cushion gives a little bit of allowance and give for the zoom pods to expand, because React cushion is a lot softer compared to the injected phylon. I think both are very, very good. It's just a matter of preference, like I've said. And as for grippiness of the traction, both are very well spaced. Both are made out of very hard rubber. So on a clean court, excellent, excellent traction. They both squeak a lot, but this one squeaks louder. And both are very dust friendly. Doesn't pick up dust that much. And on a dusty floor, you still grip, although there's no squeaky sound, but you still grip hard on the floor. And as for outdoor use, I would say both are okay for outdoor use. They have very deep grooves, which I really like. At the same time, very hard rubber. I think these two sneakers are very, very versatile for indoor and outdoor use. It is really a team sneaker. So these two sneakers are very practical, especially if you just have a chance to cop one pair. If you are playing indoor and outdoor, you can't go wrong with these two sneakers. So as for pricing, the Zoom BB Next is the higher end one. It is $9,295, very close to a LeBron sneaker. Very high end. Well, if you are more on the budget, the Zoom Rise 2 is more on the mid tier. It's still not very cheap. Still $140 US or around 7,300 pesos. But the tech that you'll be getting from these two sneakers and the performance is worth the money. And I forgot about the insole, which I love about the BB Next. It's the React insole, which I can also use for my next size sneaker if they don't have cushion. I used it in my Jordan 1 lows because Jordan 1, as you know, doesn't have any cushion at all. So you can switch it up in your other sneakers, or if you have other basketball sneakers that lack cushion, you can put up the insole there. So there is a dual purpose on the insole of the BB Next. And one of the reasons why I bought the BB Next is, of course, the insole. I really want to try a Nike React insole that is not too thick, because the ones found in the Air Force 1 and the Converse BB, it has Nike React that you can really pull out, but they are the whole cushion. It's not just the insole. So this is the first Nike React insole in my memory. Correct me if I'm wrong. I don't know about running sneakers if they have Nike React insole, but as far as I know, this is the first basketball sneaker from Nike that has React insole. There you go. As for sizing, guys, true to size on the Zoom Rise 2, if you're a regular footer, on the BB Next, you can go half a size down, in my opinion. And if you are a wide footer, go true to size or half size up on the BB Next and half size up on the Zoom Rise 2. And as for toe space, there's a little bit more toe space above your foot on the BB Next. So I think this is more wide footer friendly. The BB Next has more toe space on top of your forefoot area. And as for the width, the forefoot area, I would say they're pretty much the same. And both have plastic cases or TPU plates around the lateral part, which gives extra support on both sneakers laterally and caging the zoom units of these two sneakers. And as for the weight of these two sneakers, the BB Next is 430 grams. Not that bad. While the Rise 2 is at 400 grams. This is one of the lightest sneakers out in the market. And this one is also not that bad given the tech that you'll be getting between these two sneakers. So that's it on my comparison video between these two sneakers. Like I said, you can never go wrong with these two. It's just a matter of preference on what style, on how you play and what type of player are you. Are you a quick guard or are you more on a heavy player who plays inside, wants more cushion? It depends on your priority if it's cushion or traction or support. So a little summary, if you want more impact protection and you don't mind it to be a little bit higher off the ground and you want more plushness from the forefoot and the heel, go with the BB Next. Well, if you want a more supportive sneaker for the upper or court feel, lower profile sneaker, more court feel, and just a good impact protection around the heel, and of course the coupled outsole and an excellent traction, go with the Rise 2, especially if you are more on the budget. So that is it for me today. Let me know what you think. Which sneaker would you choose? Hit me a comment down below. This has been Marches once again. Thank you for watching. I appreciate you. I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers.